I am the choreographer for the Contemporary Ballet Odyssey of Space. I created this whole thing, and it hasn't been easy. The music just screams movement and story and dreams and beauty and atmosphere. So I was really just gung-ho on having something that was original.
I am one of the planets on Jupiter. Dance has always been, I could expel my energy in a creative way.
I play Saturn. It's really fun. It's really, really fun.
I play the sun, dance the sun, I guess. It's really such a human experience. It really struck me for the first time just how human theater is.
My ballet, it is about change, but it's about the universe, how the ins and outs of crashings and the explosions, and about how explosions make this happen, how the sun creates its own power, all that happens. The second movement is Saturn, which is the movement of Saturn. And I have, I think, six girls, yes, and a gentleman who plays Saturn, and they are his rings, and they constantly gravitate around him. And Saturn's about the old age, and it's soft, and it tells a story about them all, him always trying to struggle, and the girls are constantly rotating around him, creating the rings. And the third movement is Mars, which is very aggressive, and Mars is the planet of war, and it's red, and it's very violent, and just when you hear the music, you'll get what, when you'll see it, you're like, oh, I get it. And the last movement is the actual Venus music, and it's called Peace. And it's about how everything comes together, and it's, everything moves right. Everything gravitates properly. Everything is peaceful.
When you're in theater, I mean, if you're in theater, you're just around all sorts of people. It's a melting pot of the most creative and individualist actors and artists in the world. And as an actor, you learn that everyone is the same. No one is different.
People think this is a goof-off degree, and that you come here and you learn how to play pretend, and you get to stay up all night playing games and all this stuff, and it's so much more than that.
It builds up certain emotions, how to act with people. It helps you decide what to do in certain situations. It determines basically what you should, how you should. It's basically the study of how to be a human being, is what acting is.
You know, you can get up there and you have the freedom to say, you know, what you want and express yourself that way. And I don't think that society in general encourages us to, you know, stand out there and say exactly what you feel. And in theater, you know, if you're doing anything less than that, you know, you're holding back.
So you get to learn about yourself constantly, you learn about everyone around you constantly, and you get to be in front of people. You get to be in front of people, and they don't care. They really don't care, as long as you're telling a story. The green eyes.
on stage, no one can take that away from you. Like, no one can take away being on stage but yourself. And when you're on stage and you own it and you walk off, oh my God, you feel like you're Marilyn Monroe. You're like, I am great, everybody loves me.
I think what theater can teach is humanity. It helps you realize that the beauty of life can be appreciated through all kinds of avenues of theater, art, dance, singing. And it brings the community together, it brings people together. Theater betters our lives, it gives us an understanding of our true feelings. And I think if we get rid of theater, if it's out of our life, then I think most of our souls would die. Could you imagine not being able to go to somewhere and seeing someone sing, or seeing someone dance, or seeing some art? Could you imagine a life like that? I don't want to be in that kind of world. Don't wake up, won't wake up, can't wake up. No, don't wake me up. Don't wake up, won't wake up, can't wake up. No, don't wake me up. The sports for the arts is something that is, it's growing and dwindling at the same time. We're getting more people saying the arts are where it's at. The arts are, you know, gonna change lives, but we're also at a time where people say you need to make a living. How are you going to support yourself? Is a question we hear every day. How are you gonna live? Shame, such a beautiful, beautiful
young love. By the time I'm dreaming. That's one of the reasons why I think I'm music education instead of a theater major, because, you know, whenever I first got into college, I wanted something that I knew that I could get a job doing. By the
time I'm dreaming. How are you going to get a job? You know, you're probably going to be waitering, stuff like that. I say, you know, again, I mean, it's if you work hard in the subject, and that goes with everybody, if you work hard in the subject, you will succeed in it.
It's really hard to say, I'm going to college to get, I'm getting a BFA in acting. When I graduate here, that's all I have to offer to the table. But, you know, you have your resume, you have your headshot, and you have your feet, so that's how you get your jobs.
It was. There was a time so I didn't eat for days. There was times when what I had to eat was popcorn and syrup, you know, but I love what I did so much, and I tried so hard what I did. I just said, well, if you want something this bad, then you're gonna have to go through these bad things.
Mark told me, you're gonna have 100 no's to one yes. And it sucks, because my no's are racking up right now, and it's so, you don't want to do it anymore. You feel defeated, but if you're gonna be a professional actor, you're gonna have to deal with the defeat and deal with the negative comments that people give you, and you have to have a tough skin.
Even if you're poor, even if you're, you know, making minimum wage or less, you're doing something you like.
Mel Michelle said to my mom, I promise you that your child will not starve by doing theater. They might not be on Broadway, but they're gonna be working in theater as long as they go for it. They will be working in theater, loving what they are doing. And that really sold my mom.
We have the support of people who want to teach us. That's the great thing about being where I am. I know that my teachers and my professors have been through the exact same struggles of eating ramen every day or sleeping 3 hours because you have a show to mount and you have a final. We have to work so hard to keep, especially our university theater alive. We're doing everything. But we all want this to be done so bad, we do it.
You know, there's so much stuff to do in there that I love, that I think it's, you know, it's a good place for me to be right now. It's a really good place for me to be right now.
The best part of me doing theater is the freedom. I know who I am. And I love who I am. And theater has helped me realize I can play all these roles on stage, but when I go home, I know who I am, and I'm so confident within myself. And I think theater has given me confidence and freedom to be myself. And if I can give one or two students that idea, that energy, that encouragement, I did my job.
Thank you.
theater is such a crazy thing because as actors, you're playing emotions. You're playing different phases that everyone can do.
It's like there is no best thing. It's like you want to say the end product is the best thing, but it's not. It's the journey, but it's not the journey. It's, you know, there's no end to the amount of best things about theater, and I don't know why that is. It's just like the whole experience is just a joy.
Just other real that you get to literally be someone else for a while.
It feels so good to just be someone else for a little bit. I think that's the psychological aspect.
I mean, it's society. I mean, there's so much war, horrible, crazy things happening in our lives. We need something that brings us together as a community and as a family, as a unit. The theater brings all kinds of shapes, sizes, ethnicities, sexual preferences into its world to make up a beautiful art.
I think through theater, if you, it doesn't matter if you're getting picked on every day in school, or you get bullied, or your mom's not around, or you know something happened in your life, you go on stage and you can let that all go through a creative, positive manner. And it's almost a form of therapy.
You kind of realize that it's what you're meant to do. I would not be the person I am today without theater. I know many, many people that would not be the person they are today without theater.
It seems to be a very welcoming, you know, open community, and I think that's something that, you know, I wish all the world were a stage, because then, you know, we'd all be in it together.
Because theater requires an audience. It requires that other end. It can't just be actors in an empty space. You're constantly going to affect people. Every single time that curtain goes up, someone is going to be touched in some way.
You work so hard on something. You meet with the directors every day. You block it. You learn your lines. You rehearse, you rehearse, you rehearse. The tech kids come in, they build their crazy sets, and they have their crazy costumes, and you get it all together, and you get on stage, and you're like, man, I thought this would never happen, but I'm here, and I'm loving it, and the audience is loving it, and you walk off stage, and you know you did your job.
So, yeah, I think we need it. I have never met someone who has felt that they weren't wholly welcomed in a theatrical setting. Not a single person.
It's about change. Yeah, plain and simple. Yeah.